Hey guys, in this video I wanted to share with you just some of the foods that I've been eating during my first 2 weeks on the fast 800 diet. Now keep in mind that I mostly do one meal a day, and I basically fast for like 23 hours and then I will eat within a 1 hour period. Some days I will allow myself within a window from 1 o'clock to 6 o'clock p.m. and I will have two meals those days. And in those cases, then I will have like smaller portions. If you see like a bigger portion and that looks like about 800 calories and almost like 60 grams of protein, which that's what you're needing on the fast 800 diet, then know that that's because I'm doing one meal a day. And that's mostly for health reasons. I want to fast so that I can heal with my blood sugar. And if you saw my video, which I will link above, about why I want to start, is, you know, it goes into more details. Just letting you know that that's kind of what I've chosen to do. And most people will actually do two meals a day and they will skip breakfast and then they will eat lunch and then dinner. Lately I've just been doing lunch. Before I would do like a midday meal, eat around 3 o'clock, but I've been more hungry lately, so I will want to eat around 12:30 because I wake up much earlier since my son's school started and I have to get ready for his virtual day of school. I wake up much earlier to prep for that and to do what I need to do, and do what works for you. I am eating a lot of low-carb Mediterranean food. On the diet, you can have like good carbs such as chickpeas or legumes and oatmeal, maybe I think barley, chia seeds, things like that. I'm staying away from that for right now because I really want to like get a jump start on my blood sugar, my weight, and my inches. And then eventually when I go into the 5-2 diet, which is stage two, then I will start introducing that. And as a motivation for me, in order to keep going so that I can keep going week to week, when I reach my next week, I will have a celebratory meal, and that will consist of a little bit of the good carbs that are allowed, and cheese too, because I love cheese, but I feel like cheese kind of makes my weight stay still, but I'm gonna eat it only like one day a week during when I reach that goal. And that's a motivation for me. So you do whatever you can do to help you go on and to keep moving on this journey. I hope you enjoy this video, and remember that every Thursday I do updates with my weekly updates. I'll talk to you later. Bye. This is air fried chicken drumsticks with roasted pepper and sweet onion and a bit of stewed heirloom tomatoes. The peppers and tomatoes are from my garden. Both were cooked with extra virgin olive oil. I had 3 chicken drumsticks, which was about 300 calories and 36 grams of protein. I didn't have enough protein and calories, so I topped the dinner off with a serving of 28 grams of roasted almonds, which is about 170 calories and 6 grams of protein. Total protein intake was 42 grams. If I'm doing one meal a day, then I need at least 4 medium-sized chicken drumsticks for 48 grams of protein. The next meal is a spicy ginger garlic shrimp with a bit of light soy sauce. I made a side of stir-fried napa cabbage. It's a Chinese cabbage sauteed with extra virgin olive oil. The shrimp itself is about 200 calories with 42 grams of protein for a 6 ounce portion shown here. This meal is about 500 calories, give or take. I was very liberal with the extra virgin olive oil, and the total protein again is 42 grams. I like the one meal a day because it's a substantial amount of food that you can eat in one sitting, and you can make yourself a very good filling low carb meal with protein and lots of vegetables. I find that I am underestimating the amount of proteins though. I could have had about 20 more grams of shrimp and more calories to meet the 800. I know this meal does not look very appetizing here, but it's one of my favorite go-to meals. It's a Tex-Mex dish with 4 ounces or 113 grams of ground turkey browned and seasoned with Mexican taco seasoning. In this plate, I added 1 ounce of sharp cheddar, but I've limited my cheese consumption since this video. I made 2 homemade roasted salsa, 1 green salsa verde, and a regular red tomato salsa, both made with no added sugar or sweetener. I added half an avocado with salt and pepper, is black pepper. And also, it's not shown here, but typically I have this with 3 scrambled eggs with habanero hot sauce, With the scrambled eggs, the calories comes up to about 800 calories with about 46 grams of protein. This next meal is 2 4-ounce pork loin, so 8 ounce at 240 calories and 46 grams of protein. I seared it on a hot pan with olive oil with sides of sauteed red cabbage and red peppers with one of my favorite vegetables that brings me back to my childhood, where my grandmother would grow a beautiful vine fortress of these beautiful bitter melon fruits. This is a must-have in my summer garden. It definitely is an acquired taste because of its strong bitterness, but I grew up eating it and I love it. Bitter melon is great because it also helps lower blood sugar levels. It goes great with pork because the savoriness of the pork offsets some of that bitterness. With liberal use of olive oil, this meal is about 500 to 600 calories with 46 grams of protein. It's always a good idea to have a quick stir fry when you're in a hurry, as it gets all your protein vegetables in one go. This stir fry is chicken thighs, and I prefer dark meat because it retains its moisture content when cooking versus white meat. I cooked it with leftover roasted vegetables using a very light soy sauce. I used what's growing in my garden, and so in this dish I had green beans, peppers, and squash in this dish. Picture here is about 4 ounces of chicken, but I had about 2.5 servings, so 10 ounces of chicken at about 450 calories and almost 60 grams of protein. When I want a special treat, my go-to is full-fat cottage cheese or full-fat Greek yogurt with berries. Here I'm having some fresh strawberries, but I also put in sometimes I will have frozen berries, which are like blueberries, raspberries, and blackberries too. This cottage cheese is about 4 ounces and it's 111 calories and 13 grams of protein. And if you watched my last video, this meal will look familiar. It's about 4 ounces of ribeye steak with roasted mushroom, stuffed with cream cheese and a bit of sausage, served with a simple salad, some fresh berries, and a low carb, high protein cake. These food clips are just samples of what I eat in a week. I also enjoy soups, low-carb soups, eggs, omelets, Thai and Indian curries. I like the fast 800 diet because you can adapt the food to ethnic food or whatever flavors you like to eat. You definitely don't have to do one meal a day. You can always make smaller portions of what I have here and add a second meal to round out your 800 calories a day. And sometimes I do that. I think it's important to make delicious food that you enjoy so that you are more likely to stick with this diet for the long term. If you like these types of videos, then click the like button below so that I will know to make more of what I eat videos.